Even if you try, you wouldn't understand it.
What is up, guys? You are watching the Simple Designers YouTube channel. In today's video, we are going to design some flat icons inside Illustrator. So many of you have been asking lately how to get inspiration and where to get ideas on what to draw. If you are a beginner, you will find that even though you mastered the software, let's say Illustrator or Photoshop, and you know how to use the tools inside it, you still have no idea of what to draw. And this is what we usually call creativity blocks or inspiration barriers. And this is something that most of the professional designers face in their day-to-day work, even if they don't show it. But it's not as frustrating for them as it is for beginners. So today, I'm gonna show you a trick that I used to do whenever I face this creativity wall. When I was a beginner to Illustrator and design in general, I often found myself wondering what to design and how to start. So what I do is I start browsing the internet searching for something feasible for me to draw. What I found as the best way to learn, at least for me, is to copy other creators and talented designers and learn from their designs and their techniques and how they would approach coloring, or let's say drawing the shapes or drawing logos. So the trick is, whenever I get stuck, I will choose any platform that features other creators and designers, check their work, download it if necessary, drop it inside Illustrator and start right away recreating that design by following the original work from the designer. Just like we were kids and we had those coloring books that we used to color, the same principle would apply here. Download any icon or logo, redraw it using your skills with the software, and this will allow you to learn from the other professional designers and match their style and overcome the creativity blocks. So let's try to exercise this technique. For this video, I'm gonna be using the flaticon website to download some icons and recreate them inside Illustrator. So as you see, guys, I'm inside the flaticon website here, and what I did is I went to this search bar and typed COVID and selected COVID to find some medical equipment related icons, and I found this amazing pack provided to us by Freepik. And you see there are some pretty cool icons here that we can exercise with, and I kind of chose this one, and I also like the other icon, this one. This is a pretty easy icon to accomplish. So you see, guys, this pack is provided by Freepik, so please credit the original author if you want to share it on your account or something else. Don't repost this work as it is yours. It's not legal to do such a thing. We are not advocating by any means to steal others' work or copy them or recreate their work and claim it as yours. So please keep that in mind. So let's hop in back to Illustrator and see how to kind of exercise with this icon. But first, let me show you how to download an icon. So you just click it and you go here to PNG. Then you go to free download and you kind of get this file downloaded into your local computer. So once it's downloaded to a folder, I'm gonna show you right away how to import it into Illustrator and start exercising with it. So as you see, I'm inside Illustrator here and I have created my artboard and I gave it a size of 500 pixels for the width and 500 pixels for the height, okay? Now what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna select this bottom layer and I'm gonna drag my icon inside it. Okay, so I'm gonna go to my folder where I downloaded my files and I'm gonna drag this first icon and I'm gonna put it inside Illustrator. Okay, so I dragged it here. Now I'm gonna go to this alignment settings and I'm gonna align it to the center. So my icon is in the center of my artboard. Okay, now I'm gonna go here to this layer here and I'm gonna lock it in place. Okay, so now it's not moving anywhere. Now I'm gonna select this layer and I'm gonna start drawing or tracing my icon inside this layer. Okay, so I'm gonna select my first tool, I'm gonna select my rectangle tool, I'm gonna try to draw this first shape. Okay, so I have this shape in place. Now I'm gonna drag it here to match the icon or to match the shape that I'm drawing. Now I'm gonna select my direct selection tool here, the white one, and I'm gonna select this two anchor points and I'm gonna round them just a bit. I'm gonna do the same for this bottom one, so I'm gonna select them both and I'm gonna round them just a bit to fit this green shape. I'm gonna do the same for this bottom shape, so I'm gonna select my rectangle tool and I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna zoom in a bit to see my shapes and I'm gonna draw this rectangle and I'm gonna extend it here to the left. So I'm going to extend it. I'm going to make sure it's touching the edges of this bottom shape. Now I'm going to select my direct selection tool again. I'm going to select this two anchor points and I'm going to round them completely. Now I'm going to select this one. I'm going to round it just a bit. Then I'm going to select this top one and I'm going to round it to match this curve. Okay, so I have created this handle. Now I'm going to select my marquee tool again, or my rectangle tool again. I'm going to draw this shape. Okay, I'm going to make sure here that's not okay. So this is fine. Now I'm going to do the same for this bottom shape. So let me select my rectangle tool again. So as you see, it's just a matter of tracing the lines or the shapes and making sure that our lines are matching them. So let me select this one, and let me just round them a bit. Okay. Now I'm going to draw this part. So let me see. I'm going to drag my rectangle tool again, and I'm going to do this. I'm going to extend it a bit. Make sure the lines are matching. So let me see. Yeah. Here, let me do this same thing for this one. So now it's matching. I'm gonna select my direct selection tool again, and I'm gonna round my borders. Okay. Yeah. Now I'm gonna draw this plus sign. So I'm gonna select my rectangle tool again and draw a rectangle. I'm gonna match the widths. Select my direct selection tool. Zoom in a bit. I'm gonna round the borders. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna select this shape, go to edit, copy, edit, paste in front. So now I have two shapes. Now I'm gonna go to this corner here. I'm gonna rotate my shape. If I press the if I hold the shift key here, I'm gonna be dragging it in a 45 angle. Okay, now I'm gonna, okay, let me do it again. So I'm gonna drag it in a 45. So I have my plus shape now. I'm gonna select these shapes together and I'm gonna merge them together. So I'm gonna go to properties, pathfinder, and I'm gonna merge them together. So I've pretty much finished our illustration. Now let me drag these two shapes here, draw them. So it's easy. We will extend this shape, extend this one to this part, select our selection tool, and we're gonna round them. Now let's select this shape, alt drag it and put it here. Yeah, so we have pretty much finished tracing the icon. So now we will start coloring it. So we're going to start coloring this shape from the innermost. Okay, so we're going to select the innermost shapes and color them. Then we move to the outer shapes. So I'm going to select this two shapes here and I'm going to give them this color. Okay, I'm going to select this plus sign and I'm going to give it this color. Then I'm going to select this rectangle shape thing. I'm going to give it this color. Now it's time to color this one. So I'm going to select it and give it the green color. Okay. I'm going to do the same for this top shape. So I'm going to select this shape, give it this brown color. Select this one, give it this white color. Select this shape and give it the green color. Now I'm going to take this shape and I'm going to arrange it and bring it to front. Okay, to cover this one. And this one, I'm going to arrange it and send it to the back. Okay, so now it's covered. So I have this droplet thing that I need to draw now. So I'm going to select my ellipse. Go to the center of this droplet and I'm going to draw my ellipse. I'm going to try to match it as much as I can. Okay, it's not important to match the exact sizing we are learning here. Now I'm gonna select this anchor point with the direct selection tool again, and I'm gonna drag it to this, to the top. Okay, so now we have a shape that is similar to the droplet. Now I'm gonna select this anchor point again and I'm gonna go to properties, convert. I'm going to select this option, convert selected anchor points to corners. Okay, so I'm going to click it, and as you see, we have a straight corner. I'm gonna just round it a bit to look like a droplet. okay? And we're going to sample this color, okay? So as you see, we have our icon. Something is missing, which is the shadow. So let's see. Yeah, we have the shadows missing. So let's draw the shadows. Actually, they are pretty simple. So let's first hide this bottom layer, okay? I'm gonna start drawing the shadows, okay? So I'm gonna start by the droplet. I'm gonna select my droplet and I'm gonna alt drag it to the left, okay? So I'm holding my alt key and dragging this droplet to the left to create another shape, okay? I'm gonna put it here and release. So we have now two shapes. Now I'm gonna select these two shapes together. I'm gonna go to my shape builder, which is the favorite tool inside Illustrator. I'm gonna select it. So now I'm gonna alt click on this part to remove it, then just click on these parts to keep them, okay? So when you click alt, the shape will be minus, so we are subtracting a shape, okay? Now I'm gonna select my move tool again and select this shape, and I'm gonna go to color to make it look like shadow. So I'm gonna go to color, and also I'm gonna make sure here that I'm on HSB mode. I'm gonna make sure that I'm not selecting the RGB and I'm selecting the HSB mode. Okay, so to create a shadow, what I'm gonna do actually is I'm gonna increase the saturation a bit. Okay, so keep this rule in mind. I'm gonna increase the saturation a bit, like 10%, and I'm gonna decrease the brightness by 5% or 4%. For this case, I'm gonna just do 96. Okay, yeah. So I have created my shadow. I'm gonna do the same for this, for the other shape. So I'm gonna start by this one. So I'm gonna drag it to the left. I'm holding my alt key again. I'm gonna release, select them both, select the shape builder, alt click to subtract, keep this. Okay, now I'm gonna select this part and I'm gonna give it this color. Okay, I'm gonna do the same thing for this two shapes. So I'm gonna select this one, alt drag it to the left, select this shape, select the shape builder, alt click here to remove it, keep this one. Then I'm gonna do the same, I'm gonna select this part and give it the same color as the shadow. Now we can remove this part and just duplicate this top shape, okay? Yeah, so we have created the shadow for these two shapes. I'm gonna do the same for this one. So this one, I'm gonna alt drag it, but I'm gonna alt drag it here, okay, to create another variation. Now I'm gonna select them both like before. We're gonna select the shape builder, remove this part, keep this part, and keep this part. Then I'm gonna select this part and give it the same color as this one. I'm gonna do small variation here, so I'm gonna select this one, select this border, and just round it, okay? Then I'm gonna make sure it's on the top. So let's go to arrange, bring to font, okay? Yeah, and I'm gonna also make sure this one is on top of them all, okay? Now let's do the same for this shape here. So let's drag it to the left. I'm holding my alt key and my shift key to keep it aligned, okay? I'm gonna select them both. I'm gonna select my shape builder, alt click on this shape to remove it, keep this one and keep this one. I'm gonna select this part, go to saturation, increase it like 10%, so I'm gonna do 20%, and I'm gonna decrease it by 5 or 6, so I'm gonna do 42. Okay, so you have this shadow part here. I'm gonna do the same for this handle thing. So I'm gonna drag it to the left, select them both, select the shape builder, remove this part, keep this part, select this part, and make it like a shadow. So let's decrease the brightness to let's say 86. And let's increase the saturation by like 10% or something like that. So let me see, I'm gonna decrease it just a bit. Okay, I think this is a lot, so yeah, this is fine. Now I'm gonna do the same for this top bottom shape. So let me drag it to the left, okay? Select these shapes together, shape builder, remove this part, keep this one, select this one, and give it the same shadow. Okay, so I think we finished our illustration or our icon using just few steps. So I'm gonna group all this together. I'm gonna create new artboard. So I'm gonna select this artboard, drag it to the left. Okay, I'm gonna remove this one. I'm gonna show this one. So this is the icon that we downloaded from flaticon, and this is the one that we just created, and as you see, it's pretty much the same. So that's it for me, guys. I hope that you enjoyed today's video. If so, let me know what you think about this new format. Let me know in the comment section below. Hit that thumbs up button, subscribe if you are not already subscribed to the channel, and keep on designing. See you in the next one.